Welcome to this service of commemoration of the 75th anniversary of VE Day for St Mark's Heyside. We welcome you to this service as we join many people around the country as they celebrate a similar service as we remember VE Day. Heaviness may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. God has been our refuge and our strength, a present help in time of trouble. Dear friends, we've come together on this day to commemorate the 75th anniversary of victory in Europe, when the sounds of war fell silent on this continent. We come together conscious of our need for God's forgiveness for the sin and the desire to dominate others that leads to conflict between people and war between nations. And as we remember the many soldiers, sailors, and airmen who gave their lives restraining evil and opposing tyranny, so we also come in thanksgiving for the years of peace that the nations of Europe have enjoyed since the Second World War. We gather joyfully today as those who gathered on that first victory day, glad of each other's company and grateful for the laughter and love that follows times of sadness and loss. But above all things, let us pray that God's will may be done on earth as it is in heaven. As we join our voices together and say, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And I hope we all now join in the singing of the hymn, Thine Be the Glory.
The readings today come from Zechariah chapter 8, verse 3-8. This is what the Lord says, I will return to Zion and dwell in Jerusalem. Then Jerusalem will be called the faithful city, and the mountain of the Lord Almighty will be called the holy mountain. This is what the Lord Almighty says. Once again, men and women of ripe old age will sit in the streets of Jerusalem, each of them with cane in hand because of their age. The city streets will be filled with boys and girls playing there. This is what the Lord Almighty says. It may seem marvelous to the remnant of this people at that time, but will it seem marvelous to me, declares the Lord Almighty. This is what the Lord Almighty says. I will save my people from the countries of the east and the west. I will bring them back to live in Jerusalem. They will be my people, and I will be faithful and righteous to them as their God. Corinthians 5:18-21. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation, that God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them, and he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as though God were making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteous of God. This is the word of the Lord.
Your salvation is near to those who fear you, that glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth have met together, righteousness and peace have kissed each other, that glory may dwell in our land. Righteousness and justice, the foundation of your throne, steadfast love and faithfulness go before you. Your salvation is near to those who fear you, that your glory may dwell in our land.
Our reflection today has the themes of safety and peace, and also of reconciliation. Zechariah, our first reading, he ministered to God's people between about 520 and 480 BC. It was at the time when the Jews were returning from exile in Babylon and starting to rebuild the temple. The main purpose of his prophetic ministry was to give hope to the people by revealing God's future, his deliverance through the coming Messiah. It was largely an encouragement ministry. The message was simple. One day Christ will reign in his kingdom on earth. There all the people will live with him. The truth is an encouragement to us all to look forward to the Messiah's reign when Christ will come again. In troubled times, the very old are often the first to suffer and our experience at the moment with COVID-19 seems to bear witness to that. During the exile in Babylon and the return of the remnant of Israel, it would have been the same for God's people, the old probably suffering the most. They became discouraged as they tried to come to terms with a life of freedom after the deprivations of captivity. But God says through Zechariah that once again, men and women of ripe old age will sit in the streets of Jerusalem, each of them with cane in hand because of their age. The city streets will be filled with boys and girls playing there. And God intimates that he will be pleased with such rejoicing. I am just old enough to remember the first VE Day in 1945. I was just a few days short of being 6 years old at the time. I was living in Shaw, and I can remember the rejoicing of the community round about us. From somewhere, buntings and flags appeared on all the houses. There were street parties, and on one evening, a massive bonfire was lit in the local field, and we had a potato pie supper in the local school, which was just across the street from where I lived. And I wonder if God looked down on that rejoicing and was pleased. I hope so, because peace at that time was on the way. For the people in Zechariah's time, it was hard to believe that one day God would reign from the city of their land and would enjoy peace and prosperity once more. It must have been the same for my parents and all those who lived during the last war. For the first time in history, the war was being waged in the cities and towns and the countryside of Britain. Apart from the millions who lost their lives on the front line, many thousands were killed and injured in the air raids. And just like today's crisis of COVID-19, during the war, people down my street would be facing news of a loved one dying or going missing. But God's promise of peace and prosperity eventually came for the Jews in Zechariah's time, and it came for us, at least for a while, but it is still true for us today. When we think of the death and destruction that has taken place in our lifetime, we can have no doubt that this message of world peace and prosperity is possibly more relevant now than it ever was. And we believe that God is all-powerful. He can do anything. When confronting seemingly impossible tasks and situations, we need to remember that with God, all things are possible. Matthew 19:26. And furthermore, because of God's care for his people, we are reminded by St. Paul in our second reading from Corinthians that as Christians, we are a new creation. Through the work of the Holy Spirit, we have been given a new life. We're not the same anymore. We're not reformed, rehabilitated, or re-educated. We are recreated, living in vital union with Christ. God forgives us and our sins and reconciles us to himself. We become God's ambassadors, sent with this message of reconciliation to the world. According to the internet, there have only been 3 days of peace since 1945, although this is challenged by some historians who maintain that the world has never been at peace in the last 200 years. The truth, peace for all can seem unattainable. As we commemorate VE Day this year and give thanks for the commitment of our parents, grandparents, and all those who fought in the war, the resolve in working for peace when the world was confronted with an evil regime, we need to pray that through the work of the Christian people and those of other faiths, that somehow the world can be brought to a point where all people can live together in peace and prosperity. Giving up is not an option. And on this VE Day, the words of a prayer I sometimes use, particularly on Remembrance Sunday, are these. Two of the lines read, Almighty God, help us this day to dedicate ourselves anew to the cause of justice, freedom and peace, and give us the wisdom and strength to build a better world. Amen.
As we pause to pray on this special day of remembrance, help us, dear Lord Jesus, to be still and come into your abiding presence. We thank you and praise you, Lord Jesus, that as we pray in faith, you hear our prayers. Lord Jesus, today especially, we uphold before you those men and women who have died in active service, particularly in the Second World War, whose sacrifice brought victory in Europe. As we honour their courage and cherish their memory, may we put our faith in your future, for you, Lord, are our source of life and hope, now and always. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, stretch forth your almighty hand to strengthen and protect our servicemen and women. Support them in times of conflict and in their rest and training. Keep them safe from all evil. Fill them with courage and loyalty, and grant that in all things they may serve without reproach. We thank them at this present time for the invaluable contribution they have been making in overcoming the war against COVID-19. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, you are the Prince of Peace. So, dear Lord Jesus, enfold both heaven and earth in a single peace. We pray for all who strive for peace, and we ask you to continue to bless and guide the work of the United Nations, that we may have peace in our homes and peace in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So today we conclude our prayers by saying the prayer of Saint Ignatius. Teach us, good Lord, to serve as thou deservest, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek to rest, to labour and not to ask for any reward except that of knowing that we do thy will. So we join together and say, Merciful Father, accept our prayers for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Saviour. Amen.
The act of commitment. Let us pledge ourselves anew to the service of God and our fellow men and women, that we may help, encourage and comfort others, and support those working for the relief of the needy and for the peace and welfare of the nations, as we all say together, Lord God our Father, we pledge ourselves to serve you and all humankind in the cause of peace, for the relief of want and suffering, and for the praise of your name. Guide us by your Spirit. Give us wisdom, give us courage, give us hope, and keep us faithful now and always. Amen. O Lord our God, as we remember, teach us the ways of peace. As we treasure memories, teach us to hope. As we give thanks for the sacrifices of the past, help us to find your future in this world until your kingdom come. Amen. Collect for the army. Almighty God, whose command is over all and whose love never fails, let us be aware of your presence and confident and obedient to your will. Help us to accept our share of responsibility with strong heart and cheerful mind. Make us considerate of those with whom we live and serve, and faithful to the duties our country has entrusted to us. Let our uniform remind us daily of the traditions of the army in which we serve. When we are tempted to sin, let us resist. When we fail, give us courage to try again. Guide us with the light of your truth, and keep before us the example of Jesus, in whose name we pray and in whom we trust. Amen.
The Royal Air Force Collect. Almighty God, who has promised that they who wait upon thee shall renew their strength and mount up with wings as eagles, we commend to thy fatherly protection all who serve in the Royal Air Force. Uplift and support them in their endeavour, that they may be a safeguard unto our most gracious Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth, and a sure defence to our homeland. Help us to fulfil our several duties with honour and goodwill and integrity, and grant that we may prove to be worthy successors of those who by their valour and sacrifice did nobly save their day and generation, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Naval Prayer. O eternal Lord God, alone spreadest out the heavens and rules the raging of the sea, which compass the waters with bounds until day and night come to an end. Be pleased to receive into thy almighty, most gracious protection the persons of us, thy servants, and the fleet in which we serve. Preserve us from the dangers of the sea and of the air, and from the violence of the enemy. Bring me a safeguard unto our most gracious Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth and her dominions, and a security for such as pass upon the seas upon their lawful occasions. That the inhabitants of our islands and commonwealth may in peace and quietness serve thee, our God, that we may return in safety to enjoy the blessings of the land, and the fruits of our labours, with a thankful remembrance of thy mercies, to praise and glorify thy name. Amen.
The Collect of Peace. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed, kindle in the hearts of all people the true love of peace, and guide with your sure and peaceful wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your kingdom may go forward till the earth is filled with the knowledge of thy love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And a prayer for our Sovereign. Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, bless our Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth and all who are in authority under her, that they may order all things in wisdom and equity, righteousness and peace, to the honour of your name and the good of your church and people, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we all stand to sing the national anthem. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen and the Commonwealth and all people, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down upon you and remain with you always. Amen. And our final hymn is that wonderful hymn that we all know so well. Guide me, O thou great Redeemer. Thank you.